Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to RGN, here for Splice versus Wusaw. If you're here from map 1, you know it was very dominant from Splice. And moving into this map choice, although Wusaw, this is their choice, this is not a map that Splice is particularly weak on, to be fair. So, this is not going to be easy for Wusaw. But this is definitely where it begins, considering it didn't look like they had a lot to show on Cobblestone. But live into the pistol round here. Wusaw leave the bomb in mid-warehouse. I'm sure there's something going on here.
I think Yay will probably swing back and grab it.
Right, yeah. He is all the way over towards Squeaky. Or maybe even Check, I guess, in B main could group up and head up middle with them. But retake strap for Splice on A, as we can see.
About to call it. There's Yay going for the bomb. But Jacob, beautiful headshot into Professor Chaos. So that's an early pick so far. But look at Jacob getting aggressive towards mid. Nice play. Spots three CTs. Adaris gets the first frag. And then Abe gets a trade of his own, dinks another player. There's Davey with the dualies. 2 HP left for Wynn, 40 for Jacob, 3v3.
So 3-on-3, they'll make it into the B bomb site. Actually, Davey taking down Wynn. Love to see Davey with these dualies. There's Jacob and Ye left.
Ooh.
What a shot from Ye. Takes down Davey, only Arya. And he drops a smoke that's very opportune, but Jacob pushes it. And that'll be the round. Wusaw taking it. I don't really know what they did, though, to be fair. They pushed players into Z, they had... It was a retake on A, and they decided to wrap truck on them. I'm not sure if that's just a hard counter to a retake strat, is trying to push players up highway and then have them wrap around truck quick. I just... Honestly, when they're taking to B, they're still taking fights to mid. What would you call that strat, Hano?
As a tease? The tease just took mid control, yeah. And then went to B, so the picks happened. That, I think that's what screwed the CTs up. The CTs just were playing too aggressive towards mid, so they were trying to get back the Z connector. But as they did that, they left the B bomb site wide open, and then Wusaw was able to get the frags. I think that Ye and Odorous will actually feel a lot more comfortable on this map, and they'll be able to get the picks, because these guys are pretty nutty at aiming. I think this is going to be the map for these guys.
So, I'm gonna break into A here, utilizing Molotovs. Still one inside of the bomb site to deal with. That's Jason R. And he does drop one with his deagle, but leaves it only to Davey. I imagine he's just going to sit outside of A main. No, he's going to sprint forward with his scout. This man is brave. And he spots Odorous jumping inside of A main, peeking that first box there.
So Odorous said that his name is Odorous. I don't know if he was trolling us. But
Odorous is what I go with. I don't know. I don't think he wants to be Odorous.
Well, he capitalized O-D-E-R and then lowercase the U-S. So I would assume.
Does capitals have anything to do with pronunciation? I don't
well,
think so,
I mean,
Hino.
If he's going to capitalize it, I'm not going to be like, thanks for capitalizing
those
letters.
I haven't
like,
been corrected,
you.
And I know that he has, he's definitely listened to our casts. So... I'm just gonna keep going.
Listen,
with
I'm gonna
what I've been
ask
doing.
Him. I'm gonna ask him.
All right, Hano, you
I'm
do...
gonna be like, "Suck it, Chad." But Davey with the scout, he needs to get aggressive with the scout. The old tag and frag. If he can hit somebody down with 68 to 70-ish damage, and then his teammates with the pistols will be able to pick up the kills. So hopefully, we see like a grouped up strat with Davey and the pistols and get aggressive on something. And they can might be able to pick up one of these guns from the T side.
So yeah, stack towards A. Professor Chaos playing white box. Let's see how this plays out. Jason R with a set pop flash, but I don't think they're going to be able to utilize it. Yay. I'm going to open up Squeaky, takes down two first and foremost, and actually make it a third. It doesn't look like he's done. Finally, Arya drops him. Arya running through the smoke, just trying to spam into A, but... Dealt with by Jacob in middle. Leaves only Davey. He will take down Odorous. Misses the next shot, though his check is bouncing around like crazy. And, well, Wusaw 3-0 for them. And a decent bank account moving into this first rifle round.
Let's see what the CTs are going to be able to afford for utility. We see Professor Chaos going with a Faumus and armor. So, again, on CT side, you don't need to buy head armor. Unless you're going against a Galil, which Jacob has, but for the majority, you don't need to buy head armor because AKs are going to shoot you in the head and kill you anyway. So if you're going to save $300, you might as well use it for a smoke grenade. HE grenades don't really work in this game, so I've found. They either do a lot of damage or they hit a step and do zero damage. But look at the aggression coming out, so Abe is going to get boosted, Davey and Abe.
And at the same time, they go for a squeaky push, so Ye falls. And now Davey chimes in, drops a bomb carrier. Such an awesome way to play that push, as yeah, you got two prongs to deal with, and you're kind of chaotically dealing with one, and the other one comes into play, and now they're in an awkward spot as they're worried to even go get the bomb. They have no idea where Davey could have been off to if he's still up there, and indeed he is holding the angle, and he wins another duel versus Quinn. Odaris, last one up, 1v5. Seen this guy do some magical AWPing, but Davey from behind flanks him. And that will be the round, and Davey should be able to, well, looks like Professor Chaos beat him to it, but they do bring that up into the next round.
And two things I like about this strat. Obviously, you've already pointed out that if you push from door and you also push the boost over, the T's have to look towards door, and as they're looking towards door, you can just shoot them as you're getting boosted over towards mid. But the other thing that I want to press on is that Splice got aggressive. They were sick of getting just opening frags, entry frags. They don't want to take these duels, so if they get aggressive, they don't have to take the normal duels. So I like that strat. They're going to be able to win that round. Now Wusaw has to eco here.
I'll go with Vest on. Ye actually brings himself down to 1100. That is a decent buy, considering interesting stuff. Well, we'll see if it plays out. Vested in that vest. As of now, Abe just taking down bodies. Arya with one. Ye will come up with his frag, so that's good news. And actually a second one, so
I don't think that was necessary for Arya to get that aggressive. I mean, there was one player left alive. He shuts the door. That's fine. Leave it at that. Make him come out. But then he opened the door again and got taken down. So maybe a little bit of a misplay, but a lot of aggression.
He's trying to pad his stats.
And why is Abe picking up MP7? And Arya is as well. They think that it might be an eco?
Did they think that last round?
I couldn't have thought that was a buy. Maybe they thought it was an armor pistol buy.
You think that they're going to misread that this is an eco because the last round there was a vest on the field? That's very bizarre to me if that's the case.
If they did read it as Wusaw is going to buy armor tech 9, because if they win, then the CTs would be low on money. So maybe they did think that that was the correct force. But now we have two MP7s. I think they're going to be surprised by these AKs.
Luckily, Professor Chaos, he has an op in play, and he takes down Odaris early here. But yeah, early on, Ye spamming through a squeaky door. I was able to do a lot of damage to Arya, looking for the flash push in. Was fairly effective, but Ye was already falling off the angle. And of course, at that range, he really wanted a close MP7 fight. So they give up that advantage on a set aggressive play. I mean, again, though, it's just that MP7, but it will spread the D a little bit here. Two on each bomb site.
Professor Chaos playing quad. He's going to spot anybody coming up towards it. Look at Arya.
Oh, man.
Versus Wynn.
Oh, and he's able to take him down. Oof. Yay, we'll find the refrag. And check actually taking down Professor Chaos. That's the A bomb site open. And Davey and Jason R have to salvage the situation now. Bomb just now heading into A. See Jacob fully widescreen from that flashbang. Check at Vince. Peeks in a way that he didn't
need
actually
to get that frag.
That was very weird. Yay. Now 1v2. Looks for the first 1v1. And he will be able to find Davey looking for Jason R as well. But oof, that looked very close. But in the end, we'll be Splice picking it up.
I think that Check was towards events, right? So I think his teammate, who was Highway, expected Check to be spotting that. And the CTs just ran out. I think Jason R was the first one to run out towards connector, shot the T in the back, and then Check obviously didn't get the kill. So that really broke down to the point where it was all up to him just to get some frags as they were catching the mid-rotators. But it just didn't happen. CTs were able to retake that. Yeah, it almost broke it down to a 1v1. It was a 1v1, but Jason are coming up with that last one. So T is once again, they're going to be low on money. Wusaw seems to be getting these opening picks pretty well, but mid round hasn't been too phenomenal for these guys.
So they're off towards B to start off the round here. Davey playing the back checkered box. Jason R playing on the bomb site itself. And here we go. Smoke's coming in. Nice pop flash as well. Decent nade from Jason R though. And I don't think he recognized that he let a player out headshot. And they are going to take control of the bomb site. Davey with a nice pop flash out of checkered. We'll see if they can get the bomb down here. The bomb is down in front site. Ye is sprinting around looking for a flank. Professor Chaos somehow, I guess it's because he's just running himself. Ye is going to come up right beside him. That probably scared Professor Chaos out of his chair. But Arya will refrag, and that'll be the round.
I really like the positioning for Davey seeing back checkers too, because even if he has a rifle, he has a box to hide behind, and if they push him, if they push into the B bomb site and they have to push into Davey to go all the way down to the back of checkers, grab that gun, by the time they do that, the CTs will be able to rotate over. So Davey, another cheeky play from him, playing smart as always. But we are gonna have an op for Odaris. An AKs for the rest of the squad. Let's see if we have any strats coming out of the T site or if they just continue to work these picks.
So, Professor Chaos looking to join the A-side defense here. They're going to leave mid wide open. See how that plays out. Honestly, it's not a bad idea as long as you're aware. As long as no one is under the assumption that someone is watching it. And at the moment, we've got Arya just kind of peering down highway. It's M4A1S. And that's an angle that you don't really expect a CT just camping at. That's kind of an angle that's usually utilized for A main, but you can kind of swivel back and forth if you're Arya.
I'd be upset if he killed me from there.
Right.
Then what are you doing on that box, sir?
Just such a bizarre off angle for a highway player, but Usa taking into the middle. The Molotov sandbags, it looks like they'll just try and further the position a little bit, but two players thinking about... What are they thinking about? Professor Chaos moves back to truck. Abe... left for a moment, but he's back at fork now. This does look like a B-side hit here. And Davey and Jason are both playing in the bomb site. Oh, and yay, what a shot from him. Davey gets caught with a nade out. Jason R can't get anything done. And this looks excellent for the T-side.
And CT should just try to go for flank kills now, like go for exits. You know that you're not going to win the round, and that's fine. You have plenty of money to buy next round. You don't necessarily want to suicide into the site. Especially B on cash, which is the harder of the two sites to hold, or to retake. So if they can catch these guys rotating out towards T-spawn and do a little bit of damage to the economy, it's going to pay off later in the half. But there's opening picks we see time and time again. And then finally, Wusa decided just to group up. Once they got the pick, they took it aggressive. It's going to work out for them, and it did.
Yeah, I think a lot of that came down to the missed timing on those nades as well. Davey was just... He basically dumped a smoke, and that smoke was landing about to plume as Ye took the headshot. And he was looking to follow it up with an HE grenade as well, but again, both of them dealt with nothing on the defense, unfortunately. But that's kind of play, though, that if you're Wusaw, you're happy that you're able to secure that round, and it did work out in your direction, but if you're Splice... I wouldn't be too critical about themselves. Timing is just, it's a wonderful thing now, isn't it? And it means a lot here in Counter-Strike.
I suspect an aggressive strat coming from the CTs this round. I think that they're done getting picked, and they're going to go for the aggro once again. There's Arya, opping towards B. This is a nice setup that you can do, a two-op setup. You typically play a 1-3-1 with the opper, opping aggressive B, making sure that nobody can cross towards Sunroom. And do get a player in vents just to assist anybody that pushes towards B. No aggression yet. I thought there might have been a little bit of CT aggression.
Ooh, Arya looking for check inside a sunroom, but it's going to be Professor Chaos. Odaris falls first and foremost, and again, he's rendered a little useless with that AWP. He's not having a good map so far. Two frags for him. And again, they've been able to give him that op, but he's not able to make it work. Davey... we'll be able to take down Jacob. I do believe that was up and over. Yeah, dropping him towards the boost. So check with the refrag, but lots of damage dealt to him as well. Wusaw, not a good look after winning a round. They need to find a way back into this one.
Luckily, they did win with five players left alive last time, so they should be able to buy this next round. Even if they lose this one. They only have one player, two players low on money, but they'll get $1,400, so Wynn will be able to. But this isn't over yet. 3v4. I think two of these players should probably go towards the site, and one of these players need to make a play on the T side. As Ye goes in towards the B bomb site, looks towards headshot and see if he can connect on this guy in the back of B bomb site.
So Jason R, flames gonna be raining in. Arya needs to help him out, and he's gonna whiff onto the shot towards B main. Already peeking is Ye from the CT spawn tree area. But Arya finds check, and there's only 8 seconds here, and there's no way Ye can get the bomb down. Has to frag out. But it's Abe to find the 1v1. Wow, that was... I actually took the fight on him. Well, they win it nonetheless in Splice, but Wusa just running out of time there in the end. And to be fair, a lot of the success is purely off of Ye. He is at 16 frags, Hano.
It's more than everybody else on the team combined. He's finding the entry frags, and it's just we keep the mid-round and the post-plant positioning from Usa just hasn't been that nuts. So we saw Wynn actually whiff again towards checkers, and he needed to connect there. And if he did, they would have had a little bit more control towards the B-bomb site. So yay. Gonna go towards door once again.
Ooh, Jason R deals with Odaris early here. He's working checkered towards
I think Odaris needs to calm down a little bit. He just keeps getting picked early on. I think he's the first one to die almost every time, and he's 2-8 right now. So when you're not hitting your shots like this, and Ye is hitting his shots, you just need to play off of what he needs to do. So let him go get a pick somewhere as Abe takes him down with a nice beautiful headshot towards door. But you need to let him make the play and then execute after. Like, it's fine. Let him get the 4v5 scenario to start things off, because that's the only thing that's really working for you. And then go mid-round and do an execute. They have mollies. They know mollies. They know smokes towards B. Why don't you hit that after?
I feel like Odaris is one of those players that I'm uncertain if he, not that he didn't know, doesn't know how to play a style where it's not as headstrong, just kind of brute force your way in, but that's a lot of the success he's had has been upon that. So I'm wondering, he's just trying to get it going, but yeah, when it doesn't work out, the same thing over and over again. Need to find some variance. To be fair, he has looked for picks at different parts of the map, but still getting picked off regardless of his location.
I think this is the first time that we've seen him not be dominant, and that's nothing against him. It's just Odaris. Like, he's a phenomenal player. He hits almost all of his shots when he has the op. I don't think he knows when to turn it off. Like, the one time out of maybe 20 that he has an off match, and this is one of them. But he'll develop and he'll learn, like, okay, well, I can't do that this time. Like, this isn't working out for us. Let's slow it down. I'll let you do your thing. We'll go into it. But I think Wusaw can really develop into a strong team. I think that they have the players. They have the fragging ability. I just don't think that they've had the time together to really structure strats and structure things that worked for them before. So, like, hey, remember that time, like, you know, 2 months ago we were playing cash and we did this strat against this team? Yes. Okay, well, let's go into that. Let's go into that mindset. Yay, you're going to be the one to open these things up for us. And then we're going to go from there. But nothing against Wusaw, it's just they're developing, and I think they're going to be really strong.
All right, so Wusaw. Jacob was the front runner there, and he gets clotheslined by Jason R. Looking for another here, Jason R. Just bodying these players as they come. Well, I guess they're headshots, so that one was a body shot to finish it off. Check all alone. Davey is hopping around, question mark. Just doing Davey things as Splice. Even though it's 6-4, I feel like they've felt like they've gotten control of the match, and that might work against them, to be fair, because their economy is definitely not bad, but if they give up frags like that, that's the kind of thing that will allow a team back into things. But we're approaching the end of the first half here. Round 12 about to go live.
7-4 in favor of Splice. So I saw this meme earlier today, and you're going to hate me for this, but it was like Elmo sitting in a toilet, and it was something like, my boss makes a dime, a dollar, I make a dime. That's why I'm pooping on company time. So I've had that stuck in my head.
Wow.
All day.
For everybody that's at work right now watching on their mobile devices. We see you there, probably in the bathroom. We've all done it. Well, you know a story is going to be good when it's, oh, I saw this meme today, and anyhow.
Oh my god. But let me analyze. Sorry, boys, to interrupt. But, like, Arya actually is going to go towards checker. So we see the 1-3-1 setup once again. Arya going aggressive towards B with the op, with his teammate there. And then we have Professor Chaos towards A. So they're going to shut down anything as far as Wusaw going for picks.
Really hope someone clips you singing that Elmo song and puts it into like a GIF with that Elmo animation. Please, someone do that. Please do it. Anyhow. 7-4 as we continue. Wusaw looking to aggress in the middle towards white box. They've got a minute to work with. DMZ smoked off currently. Flash towards highway. It's an interesting one up towards the top left. I guess, to be fair, it's one where you can have a player peeking highway as it's going off. But nonetheless, Abe was hanging on to the angle towards highway. Wusaw, yeah, they have mid control, but we'll see what they can work out of it. Looks like it's going to be a crunch onto A, which could be effective, but they do have Jason R towards Z. No, they're going to be rotating out with only 30 seconds. This gives them pretty much no time for things to go wrong, but They're actually rotating Davy out. I think Slice is just as confused. Are you whiffing his first shot? He just needs to hold onto the bomb site, and he will take down Yay. They're going to eventually drop him. Davy trying to prevent the cross, but he'll be dropped by Huynh, and they are going to get the bomb down. So this is now a 3-on-4 retake as Abe takes down one, and a second check. Could not trade that. And that's a 2-on-1 that you could not afford to lose, as now it's a 3-on-2. Jason R into Jacob, Professor Chaos onto Huynh and Wusaw. Yeah, they got the bomb down, but their post plant fell apart.
I think we've seen that pretty much all half, is that their post plant has just been falling apart, and it seems like they've had a lot of struggle holding checkers. Every time they get the B bomb site, it looks promising for them, because most of the time, that if you're an advantage, a player advantage, and you have full B bomb site control, you shouldn't lose those rounds. And somehow, Abe comes out of vents and he kills two people checkers. It's just, it's nuts. You just can't let that happen. So they get the entries that we've seen over and over and over again, and they just can't hold the bomb site. So maybe they need to play. Maybe they're. I don't know what's going through their minds, but maybe they're scared. Like they get the bomb site and they're like, oh, finally we got the bomb site. Okay, and then that 2-second delay of like your thought process just doesn't help you out, and you're like, wait, I should be here instead. And then by the time you're there, you're already dead. I honestly don't know what's going on for these guys. Something needs to change.
Oof, Professor Chaos takes the head of Huynh off. Abe follows it up with a triple kill, left with 1 HP for Jacob to finish off. And it will be a double here for Jacob, but he has a lot of work to do. Drops another smoke, covers him from truck. He's going to hop up onto Fork, see if he can find anybody looking for 1v1s. He knows Professor Chaos was opping at quad, but the money nade from Arya. Wow.
Typically, I don't like people playing forklifts on like some sort of an eco or a fast A strat, but Abe showing you guys how it's done, showing me how it's done. He's sitting at 15 and 6. The only person really fragging is Ye with 16 frags on his end. And then Adair is sitting at 2 and 11. That's very uncharacteristic of him. But I don't know what these guys can really do right now. Splice is just playing phenomenal, both on their entries and not so much on their entries, I suppose, but their retakes have just been phenomenal. And it's something unique that that I kind of want to look at. I might actually watch this demo, is that Splice is pretty much giving up mid completely most of these rounds, and then they're letting them take mid. So Wusaw, how important mid is, even when they get it, they haven't been able to do much with it.
That's pretty massive, giving up a piece of real estate like that that kind of controls a lot of the map, but still being able to hold. And again, it does come down to just the way that you're playing on those bomb sites. So I'm going to see the bomb on check. It's going to be falling back from B main. It's actually holding an angle here. Arya peeks as soon as he leaves that angle. Kind of love the timing here. As he's going to regroup with his team towards A. Yay, of course, playing at Squeaky Door, and he comes out. Odorous doesn't even make it to himself. Man, that was ruthless. So the thought process is, Yay is like, okay, I know the rest of our team's not here, but Odorous, you're at A main, right? And he says, yeah, I'm definitely here. There's smoke down, but I can push it. It's like, okay, cool. He tries to run into the bomb site, and that awkward moment when you tried to go to Fork, but then you find yourself still in A main. Oh boy.
Well, hey, I'm out. Am I out? No, you're not out. I think I'm right. Out. No, I'm not out.
Definitely not.
Look at this setup now. 3 ops, an auto sniper.
Oh boy. Well, we got a lot of SCAR 20s in the last one. I'm going to go with the AWPs this time around. And how aggressive do they get? Arya's just sprinting into B main. He whips his shot. And then Check takes down Davy as he pushes after the shot misses. So, all right. Early couple frags going the way of Wusaw. They can't take the round with this advantage. Jason R gets caught out in middle, hopping around. All right, well, Professor Chaos in the fire and the flames. He gets one, but he's burning to death, and luckily he falls to the rifle, not the fires, or the flames, rather. Arya left all alone, and it's not looking so good. Maybe he can come up with a frag clip, though, as heads towards highway. He does have a full nade set and a Zeus. Very important to note the Zeus. Yay. Whiffs his shot from quad. Check. Will take him down in the end. So Wusaw with 5 on their T front on their map choice. Not a fantastic look, but maybe they can take pistol and bring it back. It's still an uphill battle.
10-5. Hopefully that doesn't hurt these guys. I mean, I'm kind of messing around with the four snipers and the M4. I mean, this probably should have been maybe, you know, like 11 to 4 or something, but who knows? Maybe Wusa wins pistol, wins the two ecos after that. 10 to 8, a little bit closer. Just inch their way across. I'm just trying to picture how this might run down on the CT side for Wusa. I don't think they need to worry about post plant anymore, so with the entries, maybe they'll make something happen on their CT side.
We'll find out soon here as we move into the second half of play on our second map. And just to let you guys know, this match is brought to you in part by Enermax. If you guys are interested in building a new computer or maybe upgrading your current one, adding a new graphics card, maybe you need a little bit more power in there. It's an SLI setup, Crossfire, something to that effect. Check out Enermax, as they've got very high quality power supplies. They've got some excellent PC cases, some liquid coolers. They got some awesome stuff. This is actually a random product they offer. It's like a USP base boosting thing, and I didn't think of a use. Like, obviously, it's nice because it'll boost bass. So if you want to like use it on a laptop or something, like that, that's nice. But it comes with a mic and a headphone jack in it. So if you have one of those laptops, a lot of laptops these days are actually built for like that mobile connection. So you have like the Apple iPhone headphones or whatever, and the mic is built into the headset. So it's just one cable. But if you have like a regular headset that doesn't work that way, well, you can pick up one of these USB adapters and then plug your mic in the headphone.
I need that bass.
Right?
For my beats, you know what I'm saying? Like, when I jam out.
My beats.
When I go to the library and play really, really loud music. I never go to the library. Who am I kidding?
Went back in university. It's a quiet place to study. We actually had a floor in university where that no one was allowed to talk, period. So it was beautiful. Anyhow, don't get that kind of silence anymore.
Like, do you like sign language to the librarian and say, I need this book?
Maybe you go and find it on the shelf, Hano. What kind of library are you going to?
Clearly
it's not self-serve. You gotta ask the librarian to go get the book for you.
I don't know where library books are. Like, what do you mean?
Oh, man.
I just asked. Right. I'm like, yo, hey, do you have a book on this? And the lady's like, yeah, this is my domain. Let me show you where that is. And I'm like, you are a lovely lady. Let's go. And we hold hands.
Wow.
And we go to the shelf. Dude, yeah, and then we go to the shelf and she's where the book is. I don't know where you're from.
There's no way this is a franchise type location bookstore, though, obviously, or library. This has got to be some sort of tiny little kind of thing. I'm used to the bigger stuff where, yeah, not a chance they're going to be walking you to it. But anyhow, libraries 101 here at RGN. Still waiting for one of these players to ready
up. My library's cooler than yours, whatever.
You're just jealous.
Library.
Just jealous.
But what's going on? What's the hold up? Who's not readied? Professor Chaos.
Professor Chaos.
His sensitivity is nutty. Like, I don't know how he plays with such high sensitivity.
Yeah, I don't know either. He's one of those players that can make it work. Other ones to know, players like Elige. You know, he plays at a pretty high sensitivity as well. But yeah, we witnessed it on Cobble when he got one of the flick shots.
The 180?
Scoped in 180. Yeah. Like, and that's not easy. Not easy, like, at all. So
I play 400 DPI, 6 cents in Windows, and then like 1.3 in game. So I have
yeah,
no
I play around
idea.
There as well. Yeah, I definitely couldn't do that. I'm whacking my keyboard all the time if I'm trying to do crazy flicks like that. But
how's your thumb feel?
Right, exactly. Very bruised. But anyhow, moving into the second half of play, Wusa on the CT front. So we take pistol and start that road to the comeback. Again, Dust 2 is our final map if required. We'll see what Splice has in store. They go with Davy being the raid boss yet again, and Arya with the smoke.
CT is getting aggressive towards A. This is a little bit unique. And shot from Czech. Beautiful entry, but they're going to go door instead. Are they going to be able to flank them? Are they going to play this slow and fake them towards B?
The walking Congo line, Hano. Very dangerous one on here on pistol as and I'll open up the door and just try and find heads. Odorous already lining up one. And what? Gets three? I thought he would at least get one, but that crosshair placement was excellent from Odorous. And he takes off all three heads. I don't know if Splice know what hit him there.
There's your Congo line. Ooh. That's what it is. They're just lined up for Odorous.
Right? That was ruthless. Well, moving to the next round.
Maybe they're feeling it now. Maybe this is going to cost them. Like I said, Splice, buying those three ops and the auto sniper. Maybe this will teach them a lesson.
This is interesting that Splice isn't force buying. Most of the time, when you don't get that plant in the first, you'll see a force buy in the follow-up round. But
especially when you don't get plant down too.
Yeah, exactly. Generally, if you get a plant, you're going to save in this round and go for the third round AK, generally. We actually saw earlier in the European matches, a lot of times they didn't, just to surprise with Tech 9 armor and a lot of utility. Worked out fairly well, to be fair. But in this situation, yeah, no bomb plant. They buy
just
a
doesn't
couple
cost
pistols,
or anything
but...
either. Because so... coming fourth round, you're just going to have plenty of utility, even if you buy armor here anyway.
Yeah. T-side benefit, as I can see. Professor Chaos is just going to hide out inside of A main. This makes me think at some point they're going to try and book it up highway, and here we go. Lots of long-range weapons to deal with, though. Check falls, and Huynh, lots of damage dealt, though. Darius is going to be playing on the E-box, and they're caught reloading. Darius takes down Abe with the USPS, and Wusa will be able to find the second round after pistol, and they do lose a FAMAS, so fairly expensive in that regard, but it's only one player.
Let's see what the buy is going to be like for them this time. They're going to go with a smoke, a deagle, and a few 250s. And Jason R obviously probably saving for the op, so he's like, nope, he buys a 250 as well. But what can you do with one smoke? Where is this smoke going to go for Arya?
And he had it in the last round as well, but he was taken down, or sorry, in the first round as well. We didn't see, I imagine that was going to be for fork and such, but this is a completely different route. He's going to be tossing it towards Z, it looks like. Quinn will take down Abe first and foremost towards Squeaky, but there we go, smoke deployed, and it botched completely towards Z. That corner is heavily smoked. If there's any player trying to hide in that corner, they're not going to be able to see anything, but other than that...
I like this plant
position.
We're going
to plan for a highway. Oh, a check catches them off guard. And this is a very bizarre round, as Jason R gets another one, tries to play a peekaboo angle against Odorous, but can't make it work. But two frags on the round, and... well, one in the second round, two in the one they're after. They've done a good amount of damage, and moving into this first rifle round, you can see, I think the one thing that you can make the argument for that they wouldn't have, so they all have pretty much all the utility they want. I'm surprised that Professor Chaos with $800 doesn't get a Molotov as well. So it's only going to be Abe. I thought there would be more Molotovs coming in this round, and that's why they would go for that save, but not really the case, just utility across the board.
Darius does pick up the op. We thought Jason R was going to pick up the op this round for them, but doesn't look like it. So I suspect this will be a default into some sort of an A execute, considering the amount of smokes that they do have left over. We do have a Molotov on Abe as well. So Professor Chaos, as you can see, is just sitting, waiting for that pop flash, and then he'll turn around with that high sensitivity of his. I like that positioning, is just to have somebody sit back towards A main peeking and have another person there for the counter flash just in case.
Win a little bit of pre-fire through Squeaky. Abe will prop it open. Just trying to make a little bit of noise towards that real estate. Pull some attention. And at the moment, they are working a boost. Professor Chaos looking to go up and over, but it's Jacob. Takes down Arya. 7 hit points remaining, so should be an easy trade. And that's going to be Professor Chaos chiming in. So 4-on-4, they still have 40 seconds to work with. We saw it's a big round for them. Want to continue that streak. Splice have other ideas and heading towards the B bomb site. So Ye has been massive, but can he be massive enough that takes down 4 players? He will have Odorous coming up. Takes down one, but traded off. Ye taking a lot of damage and will fall. And that is bad news here. Huynh up in heaven. Check trying to spam through that CT smoke. And Huynh will grab the op, and I'm wondering, they're just going to reroute. Thought they might think about saving considering the monetary situation. Might be able to make something work with Ye at the 4,500, but they will stick around. Not finding anything as of yet, though, and yeah, I think if they found a frag in that position, maybe they go for it, but otherwise, just falling off here.
Absolutely, you have like the little internal clock in your head that says if we get a frag within this next 5 seconds, we can go for it. But until then, we're just going to save. So check and Huynh saving these guns. Huynh will be able to buy probably for Odorous. Actually, you know, they'll probably swap him and give him the op instead. So the CTs will have a healthy buy coming into this next round. But I don't know why Wusa was So they had three players towards A. I don't know why they didn't have one player kind of rotate over. I mean, they have mid control. They have a lot of options. They can go mid to B, and that's exactly what they did. So I was kind of surprised that Odaris didn't go towards connector a little bit quicker to help out his teammates. So it was a 3-1 stack. Excuse me. And that cost them the round.
All right, so follow up and see they got everything that they want on that CT side for another round, but big one underway. Professor Chaos goes for the jump peaks in A main. They find out where Odaris is at. And Odaris will hit the leg shot, but I wonder what they do with this intel now. Are they trying to avoid him? I'm uncertain, but the way Professor Chaos peaked there, it did look like he wasn't necessarily looking for a duel. He was trying to hop in and see if he could bait a shot out, and again, I'm wondering how they work off of this as they boost in the middle.
Need control, important once again. So Arya taking the duel on a Jacob. Jacob coming out on top. Arya down to 10 HP. Jacob down to 36. The CTs are going to turtle here. I think this is a good play. They give up mid control, which is perfectly fine. You do have Odaris, who legged a player earlier. So you have two T-side players, less than 20 HP. This is good for the CTs. They don't have a whole lot of utility. Neither team has a whole lot of utility, to be honest. They're going to break 4B once again.
So it's going to be B. Ooh, Odaris. He's not recognizing that they're coming up the headshot lane. I don't know what kind of call wasn't given, but I thought it was clear with his teammate dying that they were going to bust out a checkered from the leftmost entrance. And he was just tunnel vision on the right one. Interesting play there, but 3-on-3. Intake situation. Jacob is very low inside of the vents. Yay, down to 50. He's going to be mollied out of heaven. Eve, I love the angle he just played. Anti-flash, and he passes Yay in the smoke. They both end up exiting the same way, and Abe grabs the frag. Splice. Take two in a row. Very important ones that force Wusaw into a save.
These rounds are almost identical. The only thing that's different is that Wusaw wasn't able to hold post plant on their T side, and as we see Splice, they're getting the entries, they're getting into the B bomb site, and they're able to hold it down. So maybe a little bit of a note there is Wusaw should be doing things a little bit differently, as Splice has been doing on their post plant. Davey's going to pick up a MAC-10. He's going to be that intel player looking for information. He's going to rush towards B. He's going to say, oh, that thing looks B. Swing the bomb towards this way. And they get full control of the site. So that 50-50 gamble doesn't pay off for the CT side. I like the stack from the CTs. And that's just going to happen. Is that sometimes when you take that 50-50, you're obviously going to lose it half the time. Haha, math.
Very clever stuff, Hano.
But they do get an AK, so that's a bonus, right? Yeah, gets an AK out of it.
Yeah, that's true. I don't know if Jason R needed to. Like, he went information gathering, peeked into A-Main, and then he had a multitude of targets, and he was thinking about how he could just mow them all down, but I think he got one and dealt with. So yeah, Yay saving this AK here towards Squeaky. Interesting smoke, and of course, if you're Arya, you really don't want to push your way through it. Yeah, he's just gonna push through though, and he takes out Arya.
That's weird.
What?
That's a ballsy play, losing it.
Yeah, what kind of play is that? You drop a smoke to prevent the player to come in, and then you push through it yourself. That is just next level.
like Arya throws a smoke too, and he looks at it, and he's like, "Oh, that's not a good smoke at all." Oh, he's right in front of my face, and then he goes. It's kind of crazy, but. You can see how like close these teams are. So Wusaw doing what they're good at is getting picks on their sides, but then things mid-round. So I feel like if you just the mid-round game a little bit from Wusaw, these are going to be a lot closer. It's just this Splice is obviously the better team, but don't cut Wusaw out. They look pretty good as far as some of the structure as far as Counter-Strike goes, but Splice looking good themselves.
So up and over. The boost here, Quinn at Sandbags. Takes down one. That's Davey. Takes a pop flash, but Abe able to take him down and leaves two members on either bomb site. Odaris, can we see a highlight reel? It's up to him. Takes the first one. And he's going to swivel. Spots Davey towards highway. The Molotovs are raining in. Can't hit the shot into Professor Chaos. What a drive-by shot from Chaos.
I hate the tech,
that was ridiculous, right? Nut stuff. Yay, 1v3, and it's not looking good at all. He's got nades, but, well, they're creeping towards the smoke. He's trying to catch them off guard at, and Professor Chaos takes that one as well with the tech, and 14-8, we are in this map.
CTs do not have a whole lot of moolah. Yeah, it has about 5k, and right now it's sitting around 3. Depends on how much wiggle room you want to give these guys. I suspect that they'll probably go with armor pistols, and they can buy probably Fomus's next round. But if they win this round with armor pistols, it'll be 14 to 9, a little bit closer. And the T's, they don't have a whole lot of money either. Only two of the players have above 5k. The rest of them sitting about 3k and lower. So if the CTs can pull off a nice eco round here, they might be able to bring this back.
Plan had one flash towards A, and I guess its sole purpose was to try and hold people off and deter them from hitting this bomb site and head towards B, but oh man, he'll go down. That was very weird. Oh man, a SIVO server plugin update has been detected. Okay. Alright, we get to continue. Looks like there's an update, though. I imagine that's
pausing at 15 rounds, just like...
Right, we'll be back in an hour with the continuation.
The last round.
Right, potentially the last round. Just counting them out already, Wusa. How dare you, Hino.
Sorry.
It's okay. I'm usually the optimist, so I'm used to filling this role. Not a problem. As Odaris just hasn't been having the map he's looking for. He's got his op back in hand. Win is going to be playing that dual op with him. And he's going to play B bombsite. Win does find Arya first and foremost. So a nice pick, but we can see the setup they're playing. Davey is jump peeking the smoke right now. He spots check at quad. And that Molotov's going to rain in. This should cue the take. And in the midst of it, they might boost in over. And that flank could come in through A main. But if it's not quick enough, check is basically hung out to dry.
What a beautiful play coming out of Splice. They've been taking mid control this whole time. The Wusa decides to try to take mid control themselves. And as they do that, Jacob gets a flank onto two of the players. Now down a 2v4 situation.
So good work from Jacob. Davey playing towards Fork. He's the last one up now. He'll not be able to find Odaris though. Odaris,
Jacob saving that round for sure.
Yeah, so he was getting boosted over as they were taking it to A. And he was the only player in my eyes that was probably going to bring that round back. And luckily he got two for his efforts. He was right on their heels as they left A main, so kind of saw them leave into the site. But once he showed up at the exit of A main, he was able to take down two. So good work from him. We saw on 9 now. They still have decent bank on that T side to work with, hence this full buy coming in.
So what I was trying to say is that Splice, they've been taking mid control the majority of the time, and then they decided to change things up, and it's a pretty good choice considering Wusa decided to get aggressive towards mid. So luckily Jacob got boosted over and got the 2k, able to win that round back, but it was a 4v4, they had full A site control. If Jacob doesn't make that flank, I'm pretty sure Splice would have taken that pretty easily.
Alright, so check. Playing the bomb site, Abe has opened up the door. Expect him to creep his way through. Check with unfortunate timing. Looks the wrong direction.
Do you think he suspected Davey to be there? I mean, Davey was right in his face as he was coming down vents.
Oh, I was talking about the Abe frag.
Oh.
My play-by-play is so good, you don't know who I'm talking about. It could be either. Whoops. Frag. No big deal. Got Ye and Odaris left to try and win this 2-on-3. They have the bomb down. But Abe is in an awkward spot that they are not going to expect at all. Odaris falls. Yay, last one up. And that's going to be that. 16-9, Splice. Able to take it in two maps and convincingly as well.
Absolutely. Cobble was pretty one-sided. But Cash was a little bit closer. Again, just post-plant, mid-round. Usopp fixes that a little bit. Maybe they'll be able to come back next time and win a best of three.
Yeah, fairly close considering it was 10-5 at half, right? I'm able to bring it back a little bit on that CT front, but Wusa, unfortunately, will be dropping down to the lower bracket. Splice will be moving on. So I'm uncertain. Let me just double check here if our other match is going on. We've got two going simultaneously, and it looks like it's still going on. Looks like it. All right. So if you guys want to tune into that, that's zubu.tv/goRGNTV2. That's Soar versus Obey. I really don't know how far through it is, but hopefully you guys can catch the tail end of that if you haven't been witnessing it already. If you got dual monitors and you haven't watched them both, shame on you. I'm just kidding. But anyhow, hope you guys enjoyed. Make sure you guys follow us on Twitter at GoRGNTV for future match updates. Don't think we got anything going on tomorrow. Friday is free of matches. Probably be back Sunday after, again, that other match on the second stream closes. So come follow me on Twitter at Sprawl with two L's and at HanoCS. Make sure you drop that lovely guy a follow. He may even sing some Elmo jingles for you. It might happen.
Dude, that's not going to happen.
Okay, fine. That we still haven't, for random things that we haven't gotten people to do, Everest still hasn't eaten a hat, so we still need to get on that. But anyway, neither here nor there. We're going to sign off here on channel number one. Hope you guys enjoyed. We'll see you next time.